Hello and welcome to this channel. In this video, we are going to look at how to calculate bearings. Before we proceed and look at how to calculate bearings, there are few things that you are supposed to know about bearings. Number one, you need to know what bearing is. So number one, what is a bearing? Bearing is an angle measured clockwise. From the north. So this is very important. Bearing is an angle measured clockwise from the north. This is very, very important. Number two, you need to know that bearing is measured using three digits. So this is also very important. You need to know that bearing is measured using three digits. If you calculate the bearing and you find that the bearing is 60 degrees, that 60 degrees is an angle. But for you to show that it's bearing, you are supposed to say 060 degrees. And then number three, you need to know that The word from indicates where you are standing and where to draw the north. So the word from in bearing indicates where you are standing and where you are supposed to draw the north. Okay, with that information, let's go ahead and look at this question here. So the question says, the diagram below shows three points OA and B, in which OB is equal to AB. So OAB, in which OB is equal to AB. So this side and this side is equal. So these two sides are equal. That's the reason why they have put these. And then since these two sides are equal, it means this is an isosceles triangle. And an isosceles triangle, it means that these two base angles are also equal. Okay? Yeah. So here are the questions now down here. So they are saying, given that the bearing of A from B is 030 degrees, so the bearing of A from B, given that the bearing of A from O is 030 degrees. So here you have 30 degrees, but because they are referring to bearing, you are going to read it as 030 degrees using three digits. Okay. And angle ABO, this angle here is 40 degrees. Calculate the bearing of B from A. They want you to find the bearing of B from A. So just as I said earlier, to say the word from in bearing is very important. It tells you where you are standing and where you are supposed to draw the north. Okay. So when they say find the bearing of B from A, they want you to find the bearing of B whilst you are standing at A. So where you are standing, you are supposed to draw the north. But before we look at that, remember they say this side and this side are equal, and we say this is an isosceles triangle. So let's first find these missing angles of this triangle. So to find the missing angles, we are going to say, since these angles are the same, we are going to say, let's assume this is x, let's give a known angle x. So since this is this angle and this angle are the same, is the same, even here we're going to have x because it's an isosceles triangle. So we use the properties of the sum of angles in a triangle is equal to 180. So we're going to say this one plus this one, or x plus 40, we should get 180 for us to find these angles. So we have x plus 40 degrees, we should get 180. So this is the angle sum of triangles in a sum of angles in a triangle are equal. So this would be 2x plus 40 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. So we are solving for x. So this is positive 40 degrees. We are going to use additive inverse. We are going to add 40 so that when we say, we're going to subtract 40 so that when we say 40 minus 40, we have a zero. So what we've done on the left-hand side, we also do the same on the right-hand side so that the equation remains balanced. So we have 2x, this will be a zero, is equal to 180 minus 40 is 140. So divide by 2 to find x. So x is equal to 70 degrees. So meaning the entire angle, this entire angle here is 70 degrees. Is 70 degrees. The entire angle is 70 degrees. Even here, the entire angle is also 70 degrees. So with that in mind, we can now come to our question. We are finding the bearing of B from A. So we are finding the bearing of B whilst standing at A. So since we are standing at A, we are going to draw a north at A. We are going to draw a north at A. Remember, from the definition, we said bearing is an angle measured clockwise from the north. So where we are standing here, we are going to draw a north. We'll draw a north. So we'll draw a north here. We'll draw a north so that we use it to measure the bearing. We'll draw a north like this. This is the north. Okay. Now, when you look at this north and this north, these are parallel lines. And this line is acting as a transversal that is passing through the parallel lines. So here you have 30 degrees. And then this angle here, from here up to here, is also going to be 30 degrees because this angle and this angle are alternate angles, and alternate angles are equal. Alternate angles form the ZD. They form the ZD shape. You can see that they are forming a Z shape. So this angle and this angle are the same. So with that in mind, We can also find what this angle is. Remember, the entire angle, we said it's 70 degrees. The entire angle we found 70 degrees. But out of 70, this angle here is 30. So meaning this one here is going to be 40 degrees. Now, with that in mind, we can now find the bearing of B from A. So we are finding the bearing of B from A. B was standing at A. And we said the bearing is measured clockwise from the north. Bearing is measured clockwise from the north. So meaning we are measuring the bearing of B from A. So from the north, standing on the north, clockwise, until we reach the line, we reach at the line that connects B and A, or BA, until we reach at this line that is connecting BA. So meaning this is the bearing that they want you to find. Now, how are you going to find this this bearing? Remember, this is a straight line, and the sum of angles on a straight line is 180. So when you look at this, the sum of angles here up to here, from the top north to the bottom north, because it's a straight line, it's 180. Now, out of 180, you've been given 40. So for you to find the bearing of a B from A, which is this one, you are going to say the total, which is 180 minus 40. So we are going to say, so this is A, bearing of B from A. B from A, we are saying this is the total. Total is 180, so we're going to say 180 degrees minus this one, 40 degrees. So we are going to have that, which is 140. So the bearing of B from A is 140 degrees. So that's a bearing here. 140 degrees. That's a bearing there. Okay. B, they want you to find the bearing of O from B. Bearing of O from B. So meaning you are finding the bearing of O whilst standing at B. You are finding the bearing of O whilst standing at B. So this is what it is. You are finding the bearing of O whilst standing at B. Okay, so where you are standing, again, you are going to draw a north. You are going to draw a north. You will draw a north like this. You will draw a north like this. So now, since they want you to find the bearing of O from B, and we said the bearing is measured clockwise from the north. So you are moving from the north until you are going to stop moving when you find the line OB. So from the north clockwise, not until you find the line that connects O and B here. So this is the bearing that they want you to find. How are you going to find this bearing? Okay. Again, when you look at this north and this north, they are parallel lines. This north that you've drawn and this one, they are parallel lines. And because they are parallel lines, you can also see this line that is cutting these in between these parallel lines. This line is acting as a transversal, and this angle here is also going to be equal to 40 degrees, because this angle 40 degrees here is alternate to this angle here. You can see that you are also forming a Z shape. You are also forming a Z shape. So this angle and this angle are equal because they are alternate angles. Okay. So now, for you to find this bearing here, the bearing of O from B, you are going to add these two, because the total, the sum of angles around the point, or the total 10, is 360 degrees. Now, for you to find this bearing here, you are going to add these two, then you subtract them from 360 degrees. So what we are saying is the bearing of O from B is going to be 360 degrees, because we are looking at the total, or the full 10, which is 360 minus these two, 40 degrees plus 40 degrees. So we are going to have 360 degrees minus 40 plus 40 is 80 degrees. So 360 degrees minus 80 is 280 degrees. So meaning the bearing of the bearing of O from B is 280 degrees. The bearing of O from B is 280 degrees. It's making sense, because 280 degrees is actually a reflex angle. And when you look at this, this is a reflex angle. Okay, so if you found this video useful, I encourage you to subscribe. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, GCE Mathematics Zone. And look out for the next video on bearing. This is the second video on bearing, but now look out for the third, actually. Look out for the third video. See you in the next video. Goodbye.